Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. We are studying it related to the chemical properties of alcohols. Today, in the chemical properties of the alcohol, we are going to study about acidic nature of alcohol. Now, what we are going to get it for the acidic nature of alcohol? Then, we can say that when we are having it as an ROH group, this gets converted into RO minus H plus. So this is going to produce acid. Right? We saw it as a reaction with metals. When it's reacting with metals, it produces alkoxide plus H plus. So it's an acidic in nature. But at the same time, depending upon this R group, the type of the OH, if we are having it as an two of them as an hydrogen, one OH and one R group, that is primary alcohol. At that time, the tendency of this polarity is more. It's a more polar because here we are having it only one carbon donor. Electron donating group is only one of it. So this H plus can be removed comparatively much easier as compared to that of the, if I am having it as in two R groups, both of them are donating, that means the polarity is decreased. What will happen? Polarity of OH group decreases as electron donating group increases on carbon containing OH group. The polarity of the OH is decreasing because whatever the electron, this partially positive, partially negative charge which is created on it, that we wrote it as carbon is there, it's attached with OH. Here we are going to get it partially positive, negative, positive. Now here the groups, if that is an R group, because it's a positive, it donates an electron pair over here. As a result, what happens? This one will become neutral. It will become comparatively neutral. So polarity is decreased. If I'm having it as an another group also, it is also donating it. Right? Similarly, if I'm having it as an 3R groups, and all the three are donating to it, then at that time what happens? All the three R groups are donating it. So polarity is least. So from this, we can say that primary is more acidic than secondary, secondary is more acidic than tertiary. That is, acidic character decreases from primary to tertiary. That is for the alcohols. Right? Now, these alcohols, within the alcohols itself we compared it. Now let us check it. When this compound is getting converted into reaction, alkoxide, and if it is reacted with water, what happens? H plus is donated very easily and OH minus is produced. So that means this acts as a base, this acts as a acid, conjugate, base. According to the Lorentz, what happened? Water became an acidic. So from this reaction, from the above reaction, we can say that alcohols are weaker acids than alcohols are weaker acids than that of the water. Right? Okay. That is your second point that we proved it. The third point that we want to prove it is, when we are seeing it the same reaction, what does it show? That alkoxides are stronger proton acceptors. They are stronger proton acceptors. That means compared to sodium hydroxide, they are stronger base. That is, Lowry-bronzed base. We can say that they also act as a Lowry-bronzed base. Right? Okay. Next, we want to compare it. The phenols. Now, what about the phenols? When we are taking it as an OH group, it's containing the lone pair also with it. We are having it as an OH group. This OH can donate an electron pair to it. So that means we will be having it as an, this electron pair from here, it came over here. Now this electron pair comes over here, this double bond goes, shifts over there. So we are going to get it as resonance in the molecule. We are having it as a resonance in the phenol, and because of this resonance we can say that this phenol can remove the H plus much easily. That means we are going to get it as a, this compound to be very easily converted into phenoxide ion, and because of the resonance in the molecule, this H plus is easily available. So we can say that phenols are more acidic than water, and water are more acidic than alcohols. That means the order of it, we are going to get it as phenols greater than water, greater than primary alcohol, greater than secondary alcohol, greater than tertiary alcohols. This is what the order we are going to get it, right? Okay, now we saw it that phenols, when they are alone, because of the resonance, they are giving us as an acidic nature. But what will happen if some other functional groups are attached to the phenols? That means if we are having it as a disubstituted alcohol, phenols, then what will happen? Then, in that case, what we are going to get it is, we are having it as an OH group, right? It's donating the lone pair of an electron. Add to it, to this group, if we say that I'm having it as an OH group attached by NO2. Now what is NO2? NO2 is a electron withdrawing group. That means we studied it, that if electron donating group is there, the polarity of the OH group decreases. But here it's an electron withdrawing group, therefore polarity in OH group increases, hence you can say that when electron withdrawing groups are present on phenols, their acidic nature increases, right? So I can say that second one is more acidic than the first one, right? Okay, compared to this, if we compare it as OH group is there and I want to put it as electron donating group to it, CH3 is electron donating, so that means the polarity of the OH group is going to decrease. Hence, we can say that phenol is more acidic, right? So depending upon the type of the functional group attached, electron withdrawing group increases the acidic character, while electron donating group decreases the acidic character of the phenol. So in general, if I want to write it, can I say that electron withdrawing group with phenols are more acidic than purely phenols, it's more acidic than electron donating group with phenols. This will be the order that we will be getting it for the acidic nature, right? So this is the what we are having it as an how comparison, or they can be asking us a question arranging the alcohols, phenols, ethers in their ascending or descending orders, right? These were all electrophilic substitutions for alcohols or in the given phenols, right? Next one we will be taking it as an electron donating groups of the alcohols and phenols. Here we will be indicating it as an nucleophilic substitution reactions in alcohols. We studied it, electron donating, that is electrophilic substitution reactions. Now we will be studying it as an nucleophilic substitution reactions of alcohols. One or two reactions, the starting reactions that we are going to study, that is nothing else but it's a revision of your first chapter of the alkyl halides. We studied it in the alkyl halides, method of preparation of halogen from alcohols. The sigma becoming here the chemical properties. That is the first one we are going to study, Lucas test. That is to identify primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols. Right, what we studied in it, if we are having it as an ROH group, if it is reacted with concentrated HCl in presence of anhydrous ZnCl2, it gets converted into RX plus H2O. But during this reaction, type of the RH, if we are having it as an immediately formation of droplet. It produces tertiary alcohol. After some times, formation of oily droplets, it indicates it's a secondary alcohol. No reaction, that means it's a primary alcohol, right? We studied it in the chapter 10, halogens. Same thing is over here. It's a identification of primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols. This question can also be asked as write a short note on Lucas test, right? So, or for the identification of propane 1-ol and propane 2-ol, what we can say that propane 1-ol will give no reaction, solution will remain clear. Propane 2-ol, after some time it will become oily, so that means it's a secondary alcohol or propane 2-ol. So that can be distinguished test for different alcohols, right? The second reaction that we already studied it, that is ROH reacted with PX3, where X can be ClBr. It gets converted into RX plus H3PO3. This is also the reaction that we have already studied it. Other reaction you also studied it for that as SOCl2. It gets converted into RCl plus SO2 plus HCl, right? They were the all different methods for preparation of alcohols. Now they are becoming it as in chemical properties of alcohols. Okay, the third one, that is that one of the important reaction. You can see it that it's a one of the important reaction. The third one, dehydration of alcohols. That means removal of H2O, right? While we started with the alcohol phenols, the preparation, I told you that we are going to have it as in four mechanism in our syllabus of this chapter, out of which one is definitely going to be asked in an exam. Out of those four mechanism, the first one we studied it as an addition of H2O, right? That is alkenes to alcohols. The second mechanism that we have been given, that is removal of H2O and converting alcohols into alkenes. That means it's a reverse process of the first one that we studied it, right? But we don't have a mechanism in the reverse form. Huh? Make it sure how we are going to go for the reaction. When we are going it for the dehydration of an alcohol, the reaction is, let's take it as CH3CH2CH2OH. This is reacted with concentrated H2SO4. On reacting with, we know that H2SO4 is a dehydrating agent. It's going to remove H2O, OH, H from the neighboring carbon, CH3CH double bond CH2. Right? In short, you can say that it's a beta elimination also. During this case, you have to be very, very careful. When we are having it as an OH, during this case, this OH is going to remove. We are having it as an two positions from where I can take it as an hydrogen. Which one will be in the perfect answer? So at that time, you have to remember that we are going to get it as CH3CH double bond CHCH3 as a major product, plus we are going to get it as CH2 double bond CH2CH3 as a minor product. You can say that this is 97%, this one will be 3%, right? So mainly you are going to get it as a symmetrical unsaturation, right? Whenever the elimination reaction is going to take place, it's going to produce symmetrical compounds. Both these carbon, unsaturated carbons, are identical in nature. Here they are not. So they are trying to always produce symmetrical. Unless and until, if you are having it as a fixed position, then they are going for unsymmetrical unsaturation also. But still it is possible, it will be going it for symmetrical unsaturations, right? Let's see what is the mechanism that is going to happen in it, right, for this. So here also, first of all, when you are going to remove this, we want to react it with H2SO4. This H2SO4, it's going to ionize itself into H plus SO4, HSO4 minus, or this HSO4 minus, furtherly dissociate into SO4 minus 2. In short, you are going to get it as an H2SO4 to 2H plus plus SO4 minus 2. So from this, that H plus is going it for protonation. So step 1, that we are going it for protonation. What we are having it is CH3, CH2, CH2, oxygen is there with lone pair, OH group. That is going to be attracted by the H plus. This is going to be attacked by H plus. So what will happen? It will get converted into CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. Oxygen is becoming positively charged. Right? So that is addition of proton. So the reaction we termed it as protonation. Now, step 2. Formation of in our, that mechanism we studied it as reaction on carbocation. Here it's going to go for the formation of carbocation. CH3, CH2, CH2, O, H, H, which is positively charged. It's going to remove it and it gets converted into CH3, CH2, CH2 plus, plus H2. So it produced carbocation. So we term it as formation of carbocation. In the step 3, we are going to remove proton. So that is deprotonation. Now during this case, what is going to happen? This compound, from the neighboring carbon, it's going to remove H plus and the double bond formation takes place. So it gets converted into removal of proton. So that particular process is termed as deprotonation. So this is the mechanism for dehydration of alcohol. Right? That is your second mechanism that we studied it. Dehydration of alcohols. Right? Okay. The fourth reaction. Fourth nucleophilic substitution reaction. Again, it's a one of the most IMP. Oxidation of alcohols. Now, when we are going it for the oxidation of an alcohols, during this reaction, the oxidation we are going to carry it out either by K2Cr2O7, H2SO4. You can also use it as Na2Cr2O7, H2SO4. They are the weak oxidizing agents. You can also go it for CrO3. You can also use it as PCC, palladium chromyl chloride. Right? So either of these components are used as an oxidizing agents. These are all weak oxidizing agents. Now these components, when you are having it as, again depending upon the type of the alcohol, whether you are having it as a primary, secondary or tertiary alcohol, their character, they will be giving us product like primary alcohol. That is RCH2OH on oxidation with either of it. Any of this reagent, you can write it over here. Right? K2CR27H2SO4 or Na2CR27H2SO4, or you can say PCC, you can say CRO3. Any of it. It will always produce aldehyde. Primary alcohol. Always. Produces aldehyde. Primary alcohol always produces aldehyde when we are having it. Secondary alcohols, that means RCHOHR-, its oxidation always produces ketone. Secondary alcohol always produces ketones. Tertiary alcohols under normal conditions, they do not react. That means they are not going it for the oxidation with tertiary alcohol with such kind of weak oxidizing agents. They go it for oxidation under the vigorous conditions. But our textbook says that we don't have any reactions. So we write it as tertiary alcohol does not give reaction, oxidation reaction. So primary always produces aldehyde, secondary produces ketone, tertiary does not react. Now what happens? Suppose if I am going it for the reaction with this tertiary, then in that case, in place of oxidation, the name I will be writing it, in place of oxidation, the same components are going to be produced, but I am going to write it as dehydrogenation reaction. Only the reagent is going to be changed. I am going to use it Cu at 573 Kelvin. Only the reagent is changed. This is not an oxidizing agent. It's a dehydrogenating agent. And therefore, the product that we are going to get it is not going to change. Primary alcohols. What we are going to get it is RCH2OH with Cu 573 Kelvin. It's going to remove 1H from here, 1H from here, so it gets converted into CHO. So primary alcohol produce aldehydes. Secondary alcohols, they are going to produce ketones. Whereas tertiary alcohols, here we are not going to write it that they do not react. Here we are going to get it as a specific reaction. We are going to get it as Cu 573 Kelvin. It's going to remove the OH group from here, H from the neighboring, and it's going to get converted into double bonded compound, alkenes. It's going to produce alkenes, right? So this specifically, it's known as dehydrogenating reagent. So Cu573, when we are writing it, like oxidation, they are producing aldehydes and ketones. But with tertiary, the oxidation of tertiary alcohol did not took place. Well, here it took place, but the product is converted into alkenes, right? Okay, these are all what we are having it as an chemical reactions for alcohols. In our next lecture, we will discuss about chemical properties of phenols. Till then, thank you.